This is a video showing the use of the thermal camera along with the materials testing system. I've previously set up the materials testing system with the polyethylene sample that I've previously put into ice water to decrease its temperature. You can see that in this frame that the sample itself is the lowest temperature of anything in the frame. I then am going to run this within the stress strain workbook that I've established. So while we're doing the materials test, it will track the force and displacement of the sensor. And using the calculations within the workbook, we can then transform those into the stress that's being exhibited by the sample, or being placed on the sample, versus the strain that the sample has experienced. So I'll go ahead and replay the video that we captured during the materials test. So we'll see as I start to crank on the materials testing machine, you'll see the stress go up. And then you'll see the apparent stress on the samples drop down as a neck forms. Because of polyethylene, the nature of that material, it's going to form a stable neck. And we can see from the thermal camera that the primary deposition of energy happens in the deforming region that's going from the original cross-section of the sample into the much thinner necked region of the sample. Because of the large ductility of the polyethylene sample, you can see that it will stretch for a great distance. And you can see the primary heat deposition is at the very end of the neck, and then as time goes on, the heat is lost to the air around it. And you can see that there's actually very little temperature change at the very ends of the sample, where the threads are, where they thread into the cross head and into the load cell at the bottom of the experiment. So you can see that the neck is very, very stable, and that the load that's required to continue deforming the sample remains pretty much constant through the test once the neck has been formed.